Seems there's some survivors at the bazaar, and the witch is one of them. Guess if anyone's gonna bullshit their way to safety, it's gonna be Dahlia, right?
Did you say she's a witch?
She says she's a witch. She claims the infected won't even touch her, because of her voodoo hocus-pocus. They say she walked clean across the city without getting touched, at night.
Maybe she knows something we don't.
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe she's just completely full of shit.
My man! So great you're here.
I saw some people in this school. Gotta wonder what they were doing there.
Zara asked me to bring him a sample from that bolter I saw in front of the school. He said they've been spotted in specific areas of the city, so I should focus my search in those places. He also said I needed to get that sample back to him while it was still fresh. So I gotta move.
There's a lot to be done around the tower. Hope you find some time to take a look at the board.
Radio signals are stronger now.
The scouts have seen people entering the school. Something's going on there. What can I do for you?
Doc Zara says you know where I should look for these, bolters. Super fast infected, covered in big green blisters.
Oh yeah, yeah. I can point you in the right direction. Here, here, and here. Though you ask me, if trouble don't come looking for you, no reason to go looking for trouble.
Words to live by, thanks.
Oh man. This means we can survive for the next couple of days at least. Thank you so much.
Come here. I've got a special... deal for you.
You need something?
Hey, what's up, Spike?
Just FYI, if you need me, I'll be at the ferry station helping Morgan prep the barge.
people started believing in angels now? If there are demons, there must be angels.
Somebody's in the school. Our scouts spotted people entering the building.
Don't you worry. As long as we...
So, at last you are here. I sent for you days ago. Are you always so slow? Perhaps you are resistant to my summons. Good. The strong ones are more difficult, but always so much more worthwhile.
You must be the witch.
Such prideful contempt. But of course you do not believe in such things.
Look, I'm here because I've been told that you have an ability.
You want to know how I walk among the Immortui without drawing their attack. Is that not so?
Huh? Is it possible?
For you? No. You are far too crude and ignorant to obtain such deep knowledge. But there is another way. Something I could make for you.
It's fine, I'd be willing to trade.
You are only here because I wish it. And it is my wish that you have this ability. You will need it to be of service to me. Tonight, you will go to the caves while the volatiles are out hunting. Collect as many black mushrooms as you can carry, and I will use them to prepare a tincture for you. That is all I require from you. For now.
officials, we are forced to communicate with you directly. You are ordered to come immediately.
This is Crane. Is that you, Tolga?
He wants to talk to us.
Well, I don't want to talk to him. I repeat, you are ordered to come immediately. That is all.
Shut off the radio!
Right!
We must avoid technical problems. Keep the concept simple.
We don't want to break him.
Hey, boys. What are we into this time?
Do you understand what a battery is?
Tolga, you're overwhelming him. Inside the engine compartment of a bus is a heavy rectangle.
I know what a battery is.
Okay. We need bus batteries with marine-grade plates. And rated at 1300 CCA or better.
CCA means cold cranking amps.
Obviously.
That's a pretty big battery.
Yes, easily 50 to 55 kilograms each.
That's equal to several large rocks. He's American. The metric system makes him angry.
We will need three of them.
Oh, you can use your brute strength. We know you primitives are keen to show how strong you are, to demonstrate physical prowess.
You think it will attract females?
Ugly and stupid. What else does he have?
How does he live like that?
Who knows? You have your instructions. Go do your interpretation of them.
Freeze.
I just want to talk.
Try listening. The first bullet goes over your head. The next one goes through it.
Stop it, Edward. You don't want to scare off someone who might be willing to help us.
We don't know this arsehole from a plate of falafel.
Don't argue with me. Let him in.
Seems Errol wants to talk to you.
There won't be any trouble.
Do I look worried?
Scared to death.
He's perceptive. Come in, come in. I'm Errol.
Kyle Crane.
This is my niece, Salier, and her son, Aaron. Do forgive Edward, but he's completely right to be worried. We're being pursued by some very ruthless men.
There's something oddly familiar about you.
There should be. The campaign spent a lot of money putting my face all over town.
Poor Sir Errol Asani, governor of the province.
Governor of nothing, but Rise has decided that any political figure is a threat to him. So he's ordered my execution. They nearly killed me once already. That's how I lost my leg. And it seems they haven't given up. A squad of his thugs has tracked me to my last safe house in the slabs. Edward was just there. He says they're searching the area. It's only a matter of time before they show up here.
Sounds like you got quite a problem.
I would pay you very well to resolve it.
Hey, you know, people say that a lot to me.
Trust me. What I can offer you can't be found anywhere else, at any price.
And I'll think about it.
Got a deal for you, friend. Thank you.
leave me. No!